Okay, the way I've decided to change this, the way I've been doing things, is instead of wandering around aimlessly looking for a quest to get involved with, and just sort of happening upon whatever I'm doing, I've decided to go and start an episode at the beginning of whatever quest, unless it's an episode where I'm just going to be wandering around talking to these different characters, which I guess I can do in separate episodes.
Here, miss. Word is you're looking for help, and paying well.
I need someone native to the dark places beneath Lowtown. If you claim as much, yes, I will pay.
I am. Let's just step into this alley, and me and my fellows can have a look at the money on offer.
Another sad Lowtown tale in the making. As if we needed another.
It's action if we want it. Always money and saving fools.
Where'd they go? Okay.
Well, thank you for your timely intervention. I am out of my element.
A foolish risk in Lowtown.
I had to come here to get the type of person I need. Someone of bloody skill, but also integrity. Perhaps the kind who might leap to someone's defense. I have a charge who needs passage from the city. If you are willing and capable, meet me at my safe house nearby.
I just saved you in an alley, and suddenly we're in business?
You're in Lowtown. What grand scheme could I be interrupting? Varnell!
Why is a Templar guarding her? Is this a setup?
I hope you will come. This matter only grows more urgent with time.
Ooh, okay. Something's going on. Well, let's loot these corpses. We only needed 50 sovereigns for the expedition to the Deep Roads, and we have... Hey, somebody just watched that whole thing go down. Someone's gonna clean those bodies up. Okay. We already have about 40, so we don't need to get a whole lot more. Hopefully this pays quite a bit. The quest continues over on this side of the map. It's all a slum. What are you talking about?
I am expected.
I thank you for coming. This matter is delicate, and I need someone of limited notoriety who will not link this to me. It is an escort, but I think you will agree the nature of the party makes this unique.
Time is wasting. Who is going where?
My name is Sister Patrice. I have assumed a burden of charity. This is my charge.
Maker.
Would even a Templar bind a mage like this? A survivor of infighting with their Talvashoth outcasts. I call him Katojin, a bridge between worlds. The Viscount and others feel that peace begins with appeasement. This mage would likely be returned to his brutal kin. He can serve a better purpose. I want him free. He must be guided from the city without alerting his people. Or being seen in my care.
If you are so intent on this, why not use Chantry resources?
My order will soon realize the Qunari presence is more than a test of faith. It is an open challenge. But for now, I must act on my own. Helping this mage shows how Qunari heresy cannot be ignored. His flight is vital.
Is freedom so helpful? A new life with that Connor seems doubtful.
And yet it is more than he has. My reach is limited. His struggle is his own.
It just seems like releasing a bird, cage and all.
We do what we can to step toward what is right. That must be enough.
You are not interested in who you might be hiring.
If you were important enough to know, I would need someone else. But if you insist, what is your family name?
My name is Hawke.
Strong. Very Ferelden. The Qunari have hardly pressured the southern nations. You have not seen as many converts or those who refused. If this action, if any action, can lessen their influence, it must be done.
Will he help? If I trust him at all.
I don't know his capabilities or if he can function at all in that collar, but I think he knows we are his only way out.
You think?
He's followed every direction and made no aggressive moves, even when taunted. Were I in his place, I could have fled. Qunari or not, I can only assume he wants to be led to freedom.
And if you're wrong, I have to deal with it.
That is why I went to Lowtown. You are either capable of the discretion and skill that I need, or you are not.
You don't just stumble on something. Someone like this.
For all their blasphemous certainty, the Qunari do have deserters. Those who seek freedom are hunted mercilessly.
Tal Vashoth. They seem to accept the role.
Even their rebels conform. Savonel observed one of their bloody exchanges. This poor mage was the only survivor.
And you think this mage was being hunted?
I am certain no thinking creature would willingly submit to this. If he was not running before, he has seized the opportunity now.
I've had dealings with the Qunari leader. He'd want to know of this.
You have dealt with their leader? If you have interacted with Qunari, you know how they treat those who leave their heathen order. The Arashok would doom this poor creature. But knowing them is useful. If they challenged you, attacking an ally would only confirm their barbarism. You are still right for the task.
I can get him out of Kirkwall. He's a bit conspicuous for the streets, though.
We must help this poor creature. He has faced worse than what I run from.
That is obviously not an option. You must avoid incident with the guards. I cannot be linked to this. This mage will be a fine example of how cruel Qunari are, even to their own. But only if this plays out just so. The passage here leads to the warrens of the Undercity. It is dangerous. But that is why you were hired. Good luck.
Picked up some Varric rivalry with that conversation. I'm not sure where along. Maybe it's because the whole idea...
Trojan, is it? You need to be led out of the city. I don't know if I understood that.
It has been difficult to get information, but look at him. Would you want this? We must have that in common.
With any luck, he'll make a good example.
Alrighty. This away. Now, a lot can be said about the way that the people of Thedas go and treat their mages.
Coming here to avoid the guards. These circumstances are...
And we win. What, is the fight not over? Oh, okay. Like I said, there's a lot that can be said bad. Bad things about the way the people of Thedas go and treat their mages. Mages are essentially second-class citizens. But the way that mages are treated among the humans is a whole different thing from the way that they're treated by the Qunari. Now, like all other modern civilizations, there seems to be a rather strong fear of mages and what they're capable of. A lot of spiders in here. Thank you. For the most part, the Ferelden's fear of the mages seems to stem from a time long in the past when the mages were responsible for the arrival of the Darkspawn and the various blights that have taken the world since that point. They also have a rather strong fear that the mages will become possessed by demons and become just sort of like these monsters in human flesh, that kind of thing. Now, I'm not entirely sure what fear there is from the Qunari, because the Qunari don't have any experience with the Darkspawn, so they're obviously not afraid of another blight, or blaming them for the blight, or anything like that. I guess it's entirely the demonic possession kind of thing, because it seems to be something that all mages are susceptible to.
Why does this creature not help in his own escape?
But the treatment is, like, see what they've done with this guy here. Kyojin, whatever the hell they named him. They tend to bind up their mages, which they call Cerebos, and at times, like, in an attempt to prevent them from casting magic or communicating or anything like that, they'll even sometimes cut their tongues out. Oh, here we go. Thug life!
Look at this. Undercity's feared by all, but there's no shortage of fools with coin who want to test it. What is this thing? Collared like a dog lord's bitch. He's some sort of Qunari lover. Maybe I should get rid of you and see who'll pay the most for your pet.
I don't think it likes you threatening its master. Maybe we let this one pass.
A voice of reason. What's he doing with you?
You lot think you're so damn right. Buying everything, running free marches like me into our own sewers. You want us bound, like this thing? I'll see you dead first.
By the void! Kill it! Kill them all!
Okay, shit just got real. Anybody left? Where's he at? Oh, okay.
The danger has passed, Qutojin. Calm yourself. Did you react because your lead was threatened? How much of this is just blind instinct, I wonder?
We are getting so much information here.
You can't gesture or stomp your feet twice for yes or something.
The sister has assumed a great deal from a few grunts and twitches.
You did what I said. Did I hit the right phrase or something? Right. Could have expected that answer. Keep control, and remember who is on your side. Of course. I expected no different.
Ha! Ha! What? What's going on? Now, the Cerebos are generally considered to be more powerful mages than the human mages, or maybe even the elven mages, I don't know. But, since they're so feared by the Qunari, and probably because they're so powerful, that they don't undergo any sort of training, so their abilities are, like, very undisciplined and unfocused, which makes them less dangerous in a certain respect. More powerful, but less... sort of like, more powerful, but less disciplined.
You will hold Basra Bashidan. I am Arvarad, and I claim possession of Sarabas at your heel. The members of his Karatam were killed by Talbashoth, but their disposal leads only here, to Sarabas and you.
Careful with your accusations. I didn't kill this mage's Karatam.
Talbashoth killed them. That battle was expected. The survival of Sarabas without his Arvarad was not. I do not know how you come to hold his leash, but you have no claim in the Qun. He will be returned and this crime cleansed.
And if he doesn't want to go back?
Sarabas, show that your will remains bound to the Qun. He has only followed you because he wants to be led. He is allowed no other purpose.
The sister called him Katojin. You are Sarabas?
Sarabas is his role and his name, as you understand it. It is the accusation and acknowledgement of being a mage.
And you are Arvarad?
My role is to hold the leash and hunt the Grey Ones who leave the Qun. Or Baz, who have not yet been enlightened.
You don't care that someone abused your dead to get you here?
No doubt they were cast from your shoulders as you or your partner thieves grew weak. It is a crime whose victims are beyond caring. It will be dealt with, but the greater threat is clear. It is my role to secure Sarabas. It is the role of another to purge the perversions of your kind.
Pleasant fellow.
He is bound and abused, and you want him caged. Why?
The power that he has, that all Sarabas have, draws from chaos and demons. They can never be in control.
So you fear them? Like so many others.
We leash Sarabas because they are dangerous and contagious. Not even your Templars fully grasp that threat.
Is a mage like Bethany so threatening? I don't see it.
I'd hope not, sister.
You and Sarabas, Baz Sarabas, are of the same womb? Vashidan! Neira Sitar Karasam! You spewed your words at me like a demon trying to poison my control. Like this mage, the Qun requires your death.
But we're no threat to each other.
Baz Sarabas, you will be no threat to each other.
Time for a killing. We almost got him. Got him.
Can you stand?
I am unbound. Odd. Wrong. But you deserve honor. You are now Basvaran, worthy of following. I thank your intent, even if it was wrong. I know the will of Arvarad. I must return as demanded. It is the wisdom of the Qun.
So after all this, now you want to die?
I do not want to die. I want to live by the Qun.
Which means dying.
Yes. Is that hard to grasp?
Avarad couldn't kill me. Perhaps he was wrong about your death, too.
Losing to you does not make him wrong. He spoke the Qun. I have chosen. It is bred in the bone.
Existing is not a choice.
It is the only choice. As it tal eb, it is to be.
Others of your kind live outside the Qun. You could join them.
They are not my kind. I am Qunari. They are not.
They have chosen to be free.
Free? They have refused what they are. I can't choose to not be.
Patrice might take you back if death is the only other option.
The sister was not honest.
What do you mean?
I cannot say what she wanted, but it was certainty, not of the Qun. And her guard smelled of death.
Could you have returned if I'd let these others live?
No.
You were doomed from the start.
I was outside my Keratom. I may be corrupted. I cannot know. How I return is my choice. It must be. But that does not mean there is no meaning.
My job ended when we exited the city. The rest is up to you.
You know of certainty and borders. You are closer to the Qunari than you admit. Your role would change little if you accepted the Qun. Take this secret thing, Asfaran. Remember this day.
But the creature was free.
She may not have known about this, but clearly Patrice set a trail right to us.
Why arrange this only to subvert it? I need answers.
Oh, man. That was nuts. So we go through all the trouble of taking this Cerebos out of... away from the city, and in a sense protecting him from his own people, even. Then he commits suicide, and it all comes to an end. And the reason why he did it, though, was such the interesting thing. Hey, there's a ship out there. Gotta go back to finish off the quest. I'm stuck. Anyway, the reason why he killed himself is because that is what his role in society, the Qunari, the Qun, says that he must. He has to kill himself because that is his role in life. After his keeper died, his life came to an end too. And he knew that from the beginning. But he wanted to return to the Qun so that he could go and basically see his life come to an end. Because that is his role.
Leave nothing. It must be clean, with no ties. Hawke. It was Hawke, right? From the streets. You took the Qunari from the city? Without incident?
You know what we faced.
Mind your tongue, Ferelden.
Please, do speak your mind.
This was a damned roundabout way of trying to kill me.
Do you really think yourself so important? If someone saw an opportunity in the mage, if the Qunari murdered those who tried to help it, yes, that might be useful. But it wouldn't be personal. The Chantry must see the Qunari as the monsters they are. If someone ushers that along, some sacrifices are justified.
Your Qutojin killed himself rather than be free.
I assumed he wanted to escape, just as I would. My pity is genuine, but they are not like us.
I want no part of your little war. Pay me what I'm due.
Take your coin. Disappear back into Lowtown. Rest assured, I will not make the mistake of looking for help outside the Faithful again. The stakes, eternity, are just too high.
We'll be hearing from that one again.
We got 7 sovereigns out of that. Is that a birthday cake? So, we're looking at this and you... The whole incredible difference that you see between the cultures of the Qunari and the human and elvish societies and dwarven societies, all the different races and different groups in this game series have very different sort of like perspectives on life and all that kind of stuff. Dwarves are different than humans, the elves are different than the dwarves, the Qunari are different than everybody. So it's a little bit of a culture shock with a lot of these different groups coming and living together inside of the city. And it seems kind of strange from our perspective to realize that Sarabas was willing to die rather than submit himself to the idea of being free. That's unnecessary. They all dead? No, there's one more down there. So as strange as it may seem to us, the Qunari was, in fact, willing to die more than be free. Just that the societal pressure is that strong. It's not that all Qunari are like that, meaning the race, not the society. Not every one of them, like the Val Tassoth or whatever the hell they're called, are ones that decided that they see the human society here and say, hey, you know what? Maybe that's what I should do instead. This seems better for me. But for the most part, the level of indoctrination with these people is so great that... they, for the most part, just blindly follow it. Then there was his sister Patrice. Now, it was probably obvious to everybody that she was not genuine in her desires to help the Sarabas escape. She just seemed like a shifty individual. And, well, turns out we were right about that one. Seems as though her plan was more along the lines of, we try to help this Sarabas escape. She hires some humans or whatever to go and help this thing escape, this person escape. And, well, the Qunari catch up. They kill everybody there. News spreads that the Qunari are these brutal, savage things, which everyone already knew. They just need a big event to sort of push public opinion against them so strongly. And then the city ejects the Qunari from the city. The city guard eject the Qunari from the city, or perhaps kill them, or something like that. Everything didn't exactly go as planned. The Qunari attacked us, but we killed them. Now, that obviously isn't going to look too good for the Qunari as far as the rest of the city is concerned, but not as bad as if they had killed us. So we survived, and that didn't exactly work to Patrice's plan, but we got our money anyway, and the episode gets to end.